Don't stop at the 3 points. Extend the 3 points. Okay or not? So I'll remind again, when you're drawing your points, a lot of you tend to do this. A lot of you tend to do this. You draw one, you draw two, you draw three, then you draw like that. You stop. Try to extend your line. Extend your line. Okay, ma? Try to extend your line. Quick it a go. In this case, we cannot extend. In this case, it stops. It goes in this manner. Okay, also it's a very challenging question. So from here, this is our graph. So, this one, is it correct? Is it correct? Partially. So, good to have the line. Yes? Going up, okay, like this, huh? Actually wrong. Here it's actually wrong. Yes.
You know, you write the coordinates, do you erase it after?
No, you leave the coordinates there. The coordinates is evidence of your working.
But you know, the other teacher in other class say, like, you should erase your coordinates.
No need. Leave it there. It's not. It's just different practice. Okay, the reason very simple. Why do I ask you to keep your coordinates? So you can use it to calculate gradient. Right, someone said. So you can use it to calculate gradient. Okay, no? So for example, if you have a coordinates, example here you have 2, 5, here you have 1, -2, for example. Why do I ask you to keep your coordinates? It's so that it's easy for you to calculate gradient. So that's the idea. You don't have to erase. Then after that, on a sheet of graph paper, use a scale of 2 cm to represent 1 GB. And 1 cm to represent $5. Take note that I ask you to do some change that day, huh? Okay, so just plot from 0 to 8 will do how much will the customer be charged if he uses the monthly data. Okay, so here, what's the equation for the straight line? What's the equation for this straight line? Okay, let me just change. Okay, so for this, right? Okay, if you notice the question is a bit flawed, because honestly, if I follow this data, does it? So you can see that the data looks like that. So I give you a while. If you look at this, I'll explain the solution very shortly. So the graph really looks something like this. Okay, there's a y, there's an x. Okay, so from here, when you start, the point is you have 3 GB. Okay, this x refers to the number of gigabyte, and this y refers to the amount that you pay. So when you put 3, you know that you pay $42. Okay, $42. So example 3 or 42 will be somewhere here. So 66 will be somewhere here. 8. For those who didn't have graph paper or didn't draw a graph, at least you must have something like that. Okay, after that you go up the line again.
But Mr. Tan, you know when you extend the line, right? What? Because some lines have the different. You know, like some lines have. It's not all the way straight, it has some.
Oh, it's always straight. Linear line will always be straight. Why it goes at right? You're always straight. Always straight. Okay, can I? Yes. Yeah. I will continue explaining. Okay, so what question do you have?
The 8 and the
102
is the end of the line, so don't need to extend
the line. Extend a bit, if you can. But if it's already at the peak of the graph paper, then you can stop. Yeah. Okay, so from here, okay, if you notice, this portion D, in C, for by right, okay, they put, I should use this. For x greater than 2, for x greater than 2. Sorry, my bad. Okay, so we keep this one for x greater than 2. So for x greater than 2, sorry, I'm sure to change.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, same. Okay, for C, it's the same. Okay, so they are talking about this line, They are talking about this line. Next, like that. Putting some hula, you do it again, do it again. By the mandate of heaven, come. Put your foot on this table, and do it for me to see. Next! Nobody says no to me! Do it now! I come to fight. 4, 3, 4, 1. Dear parents, you can see this is what next does to my class. Okay. Okay, so from here, I go a bit softer. Okay, they are talking about this is your C. Okay, so from C, okay. I go to 2. This will be 2, 30. Okay, okay, ma. So this is the actual line. Okay, so this is 30. This is 2. Okay, so from here, they are asking, you'll see this part, right? Okay, so you think about extending this line. Okay, tell me what's the y-intercept. The y-intercept should be 6. It should be 6. Okay, so we're talking about this line. It should be 6. Okay, if you just extend the line, you can find that it's 6. So for this, what's the gradient? You can see that the gradient is 12. Because for every 2 gigabyte, there's an increase of 12. So it's something like y equals to 12x plus 6. Okay, this is the equation of this line. Yes, everything is on the graph paper. Okay, if you are doing a graph paper question, everything you do on the graph paper. Clear? Yes, you do on the back of the graph paper. Okay, ma'am? All on the graph paper. Sure? Even the working. Yes. I say again, if you are doing a graph paper question, Musha, you okay? Musha? So you look at like your boyfriend run away. Okay. So
No.
It's a guy.
Obviously.
Okay,
that's very useful information. Okay, so 2 comma 30. Can we sit down? Okay, so from here, how much will I be charged if I use 7? So what do I do? From 7, I mean, I just read. Quite easy, quieter now. Just read. Okay, ma? Okay, ma? So this is the amount that I pay. From the graph, using the graph. Okay, like I said, using the graph. This one erase, don't need to do. Okay, so this one erase. Okay? Listen carefully.
For part E, this part erased, no need to do. This part, write down using the graph. Do not use the equation to sub 7 inside. Use the graph, okay? Yes, just use 7, 7 gigabit, you read it up. You can find the cost that you pay. Am I clear? No, that is not using the graph. Answer is 90. Okay? So for this one, you don't need to do. I say again, for E part 1, you are supposed to use the graph. I can say 10 times and you don't do. Okay? Hey guys, I say again, I just said it and there are two people in front of me who are not doing it. Using the graph. For E part 1, you must use the graph. Cannot use equation. Common mistake, when I say use the graph, some people like to do this. Because they know that the equation is 12x plus 6. What they do is they sub y equals to 12x plus 7, right? They put x to 7. Okay, then they got 90. If you do this, it's wrong. So can you just check your friends if they are doing this? If they are doing this, despite me saying it three times, go and slap them. Can you check your buddies one now? Can you just check Tanya's one? Can you check Kusha one? Can you check Kula one? I see that. Anyone did it? Okay, so I say one more time. Using the graph. If I say using the graph, it means that you have to read your answers. You have to read your answers from the graph. You have to read your answers from the graph. You understand? Can I? You read your, you cannot use equation. Do not use algebraic method. Do not use algebraic method. Okay, so what this is what I mean by algebraic. Ula purposely do wrong to help me show you. Mulan is did it on purpose, but the correct solution is somewhere on the software. So this is called algebraic method. So if you do this, it is wrong. If the question says using the graph. Clear or not? Clear? Okay, Ting Kai, repeat what I just said. Ting Kai, go teach you all.
Are you
saying
that algebraic method is wrong?
Why? What's the question say?
Use the graph.
So if they say use the graph, what must you do?
Use the graph.
I never ask you. Why you reply?
Use the graph.
So you must use the graph for him. Okay, man. Here, heard him. Heard the man. Okay, now listen carefully. Shut up, Hamza. They have to stop looking at each other. We should be looking at girls, not boys. Okay, so example 6.2. I want to run through a question with you. If you understand what I'm saying, you just nod your head, you give a thumbs up. If you don't buy what I'm saying, just ask me to explain. Okay, ma? To understanding this kind of question is very important. Okay? You read in English, but you think in math. So for this, right, a technician is a computer firm. I drove from my workshop to repair a customer's computer. Okay, so you can see that this part, okay, let's break this down. This graph looks a bit hard to analyze, but what does the y-axis represent? What does the y-axis represent? Workshop. Okay, so if here I'm at the number 3, what does the number 3 represent? It means that I am 3 kilometers from the workshop. What does the x-axis represent? Workshop. From the time it took. So you see, I drove from his workshop to repair a customer's computer. So you can see, as I drove, my right, I should be further away from the workshop, right? I drive right, drive from this point A, then stop. Then from A to B, you notice my distance never changed. What happened? My distance never changed. It likely from A to B, what's going on? Miss, what am I doing here? What's happening at AB? Hardy.
They're repairing the computer.
Who said car broke down? Natalie, Okay, Natalie is a nice girl, give her a chance. Okay, so the idea is he's repairing the computer. Agree? This was the portion when he's repairing. He's repairing, huh? Can you see? He's repairing. Then after that, on his way back, so you read, the graph, right, is trying to tell you a story. The graph is trying to tell a story. Listen. So from B to C, I travel on the way back, and from C, I stop again for a period of time. Why? What's happening here? I'm preparing the second computer. Very good. I'm preparing the second computer. Huh? It's repaired again. And this distance time graph shows the entire journey. So now I just ask you, okay, so here I'm preparing for the first customer, here I'm preparing for the second customer. Okay, so you can see that for the first customer, I stop for a total how long? I stop from the 10 minute interval until the 30 minute interval. How long is this, Tanya? I stop from 10 to 30. How long did I stop to repair? 20 minutes, huh? Okay, Hamza. So I went from... the graph not very smooth. Sorry, let me scroll. Okay, 10. So I stop from 35. This is like from 20, 35, right? How do I know, huh? What do you mean? Sorry. How do I know, huh? So it's half, it's half. Okay, so it's half. This is 2.5 squares. If 5 squares represent 10, 2.5 squares represent 5. Okay, ma? Can I? Okay, this. Yes. Take my last question. Sorry. So this is 35, ma? Are you okay? This is 35, ma? This is 35, ma? Can I? So from here to here, again, from 35 to 55, let me ask Caleb, how long did I spend repairing the second computer? 20 minutes as well. Oh, so, 20 minutes as well. Okay, ma? Can I? So this is the graph. And once you can see the story that the graph is telling you,
wait,
life is wonderful. Can see now? 20 minutes. Cannot see now? Oh my, my poor handwriting. Okay. I promise you what myself from now on. It's 20 minutes. 20 minutes. Okay, ma? I hope you all indulge me as I write, you also write. Okay, as I write, as I fill in the graph, you also follow me. I'll show you all the way. Okay, ma? Can I? 20 minutes. Can? Can I? Can see? Honey, can see?
Wait, Mr. Baraka, is 30 minutes.
30? Huh? You see, 35 here.
Oh, I saw 25.
55 minus the 35 is 20.
I saw 25.
Yeah. 25 minus 25 is 20. My son can do this.
No, I saw 25.
Okay. Okay. So, how far was the workshop? From the first workshop was the first customer. So, okay. Here's how you help me. First customer is where? This one. AB or CD?
AB.
Maybe, okay. How far is the workshop from the first customer? So my workshop is
9 km.
What you?
8 km.
8 km. Chinese are you?
Thank you.
Sports day. How long?
9 km.
How to get 9?
You take the what's it called? Where is it?
Come here and show me how you get 9. Okay, we are saying 9, how is it 9?
C from D,
C, take
9 minus
5. So the answer is 4. The answer is 4. What do you think? The question is this, we are looking at this now, guys. How far of the workshop was the first customer? We are looking at this question now. So Pierre's going to teach you.
Oh, how far was the first customer was? Zero
is 9 km. Okay, okay, say again, teach again. Okay, look carefully,
yeah. You see from...
Where's the workshop? Which distance? Here, okay.
All the way to here.
Okay, so here to here is 9, okay, it's 9. Okay, thank you, thank you. Round of applause, okay. Yeah. Yeah. So if you cannot answer right, it means that only one thing. A lot of time, students, they don't read the question in detail. They don't read the question in detail. So when you do maths, you must have a brain for reading in English, but translating it to math terms. Okay, huh? So first workshop is here. I travel to the first customer. I look at the difference in Y. It's 9 units. Therefore, 9 kilometers. Sometimes to some of you, it's very easy, it's very logical. Sometimes for you, some of you give it in time. So my suggestion, do more. Do more and allow yourself to engage more in such problems. Now find the gradient of the following line segments. OA, what does it represent? AB, what does it represent? BC, CD, DE. Need me to go through? I think don't need now. Have you all done? Who has not done this part? Who has not done this part? Who have not done this part? Can we do? 1, 2. Okay, just raise your hand. Can we do? 1, 2, 3. Do we have you done? The graph. Okay. Just hi. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You got it? You nation school already? Natalie do already? Did they do it? Did they just do it? No. Hey, be honest, be honest. I ask one more time. Honest. Don't cheat me. I to me, don't no point cheating me. I want to ask 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Who haven't do yet? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, more than 10 people. Okay, I give you about 5 minutes. Can you just help me complete this? Complete this. Yeah.